Thank you. Thanks. It's so great to be here. I'm very thankful for all the synchronicities and phenomena that enabled me to share a little story with you here today. So I'm Clark Shah-Nelson. You can follow along with the link there if you'd like to view the slides yourself or insert some comments. I'm taking off my assistant dean hat today as the instructional design and admin at the University of Maryland School of Social Work in Baltimore. It probably took me longer to drive here than some of you to fly here, I'm sure. I'm putting on my student voice hat. I'm a student. As of a couple of years ago, I started on an online doctoral program in business administration. And as I got it started in my studies as an online student, I quickly found myself overwhelmed with the amount of reading materials, PDFs, articles, and so on. This is not me, but you know, could be. And I started thinking, I really need a way to collect all this information better. And a lot of what we're doing in my program is evidence-based management, sort of writing papers and so on, and synthesizing what you find in a number of articles. So you may read 10 articles or something like that and then compile a paper, like most classes in doctoral studies. And of course, a lot of people say, oh, you need a reference manager, you know, get Zotero or Mendeley and so on, and Mendeley kept crashing on me. But what I found was that the reference managers, they did some good, useful things for storing documents and citations and stuff like that, and keeping some notes and highlighting some things. But also I found that there were some things that it wasn't doing that weren't very helpful that I needed, that I was looking for, like easily searchable highlighting on documents or tagging things across documents so that it would help me write papers and so on. So I started, you know, thinking about, well, how can I go through all these papers and highlight things that are common across all these different papers and then use that when I need to write my own paper, kind of like you see here, like, you know, these parts are green, these parts are pink, these parts are blue, and so on. And what I really needed to do is synthesize all of these bits and pieces down into a paper. I couldn't do that. Zotero wasn't really helping me out. And so I thought, oh, that Nate, he's doing something interesting with this new tool. I wasn't even that new. I'm kind of late to the party. But so I'm thinking, there's got to be some way that I can, you know, take these notes and bits and pieces and kind of put them together under different categories and so on, so that it'll help my writing, essentially. And so I made contact with Nate, and I still had it in my Twitter direct messages, so I figured I'll just put that in there. I was like, you know, hey, I'm wondering if this project you're working on has something that I can use for tagging and highlighting and annotating on PDFs and storing them and searching for them and so on through journal articles. And he was, of course, like, yeah, you can definitely do a lot of that. And I went on saying, well, I've got all these PDFs that I highlighted in preview that I'd really like to, you know, just be able to, like, import or something and use those highlights. Well, I couldn't do that necessarily, but, of course, I can open those PDFs in the web browser and then open up the layer of on top of them to take annotations and highlights and so on. And so enter hypothesis into my world, thank you. And it was exactly what I was looking for. It turns out that I was able to basically create groups. I just created like a private group for each course that I was in, so a way to organize myself. So, you know, each of these DMGs is a different course that I was taking. And then within each course, I would have, you know, various tags for various things I was doing. But the other thing I decided to start doing was the first annotation I would always take on every new PDF I would read or paper I would read would be the APA citation, because in the program, it's very important to do all your citations in APA format and so on. And so that way I figured whenever I am writing my paper and I want to quote somebody or get an idea from a particular paper, I'll have that citation, you know, right there along with all the other citations from that paper. And of course, I also tagged it with citations, so I can easily just pull up the citation tag and see all of my citations. Or if I'm looking at a quote quote from a particular paper, I can get back to that citation and just easily pop that into my reference list. So in essence, I've kind of sort of started using it to replace Zotero in a lot of ways, because then I can go beyond that with all of these tags that I'm using. And a lot of times I'm thinking, okay, I got to write a paper that's going to have an introduction, it's going to have something on the methodology, it's going to have something on the findings, some recommendations, it's going to have something on research design. And so these all became tags that I would use across all these articles, right? So as I'm reading papers 1 through 5, I'm tagging, this is going to be good for the introduction on this one, and this is going to be good for the introduction on that one. Oh, here's a good recommendation. And so by tagging all of these things with limitations or findings or, you know, research design, then as I'm writing the paper, I can easily just pull up that tag and say, okay, here's, now I'm up to my findings. Here are all the things that I tagged with findings across these 10 or 20 documents that I just read. So that was exactly what I was looking for, was a way to synthesize this to make it easier to write, and especially when you need to cite all of these things with APA citations and so on. So again, when it comes down to the writing, I come to my recommendations tag, then it lists, here are my 5 papers, and I can just click on them and get to those citations. You know, I found it very useful. Of course, this is a very, you know, unique to me sort of use case with the self-limitation that I'm not using a lot of the functionality that could be there, like collaborating with other students, discussing things with other people, using actual groups in the class. Basically, I'm just doing it, you know, on my own. And of course, it wouldn't be a Clark, Shaw, Nelson presentation without bringing up a few of my most wanted items, my wish list of things that I'd love to see in the future. So an offline mode where I can, you know, I'm on a flight or at the airport or whatever, and I can still annotate on PDFs, for example, and then when I land and get on Wi-Fi again, it'll upload those. Would love to be able to take things that I've already highlighted in preview on the Mac, for example, and then have those sort of translate, although I'm sure it's proprietary enough that may never, ever happen. But multicolor highlighting for different tags and for different people, if you are working in a group, I think would be really cool. And some of this probably already exists. I'm learning things already this morning. Sounds like there's some tools out there. Like John's tool that will help with the interoperability and the compatibility with coding software like Max QDA and Atlas TI and Deduce, so that you could actually, like, I could read these PDFs, I could be tagging them in Hypothesis and doing all the stuff I normally do, and then perhaps import that into a coding software so that I can do further analysis and so on with that. I also think it'd be really cool to do some bulk operations, like, for example, you know how, so there's the APA citation, which is good for the references, but then all of the different things that I've highlighted, if I could just add a tag after the fact that would go across all of them, or I could choose a bunch and then sort of do a bulk operation to add a particular tag after the fact, then I could have the actual, you know, parenthesis inline citation I could add in there. It'd make it even easier when I'm writing the paper to be able to cite the author or something like that. Or moving things from group to group after the fact, things like that. So, that was pretty quick. Hopefully, you know, helps our time situation here as well. And I'll entertain any questions you might have at this point.
What's the URL for the slides?
Oh, the slide URL is v.ht/hypothesis review.
And just as a note, everybody who's presenting, I'm going to ask you to either link your slides, if they're already online, to the program. And if you can't do that, email them to me, and I'll put them in a place, and I'll link them so they can be shared, if you would. That'd be great.
Another question.
John, can you use the mic, please?
Oh, sure.
Here, I'll offer you.
I'm just wondering what you would need for interop with Max QDA and Vivo. What would that require?
So typically what will happen is, so I was using those for coding, right, for a systematic review. And so if I had already read the articles in, say, Hypothesis, well, so what I normally do now is, without using Hypothesis, I would import those PDFs into the tool, like MaxQDA, and then highlight things and basically add codes to it, which are essentially tags. And then what it does is it analyzes those codes and shows me how many you have across different documents and a lot of different analysis. So I guess essentially what it would be some way to sort of import everything I'd done in Hypothesis, where the tags would become codes in that software.
So you'd have to match the import format for each of those tools.
Yeah,
probably.
Yeah,
like
I guess
they don't
so.
Use one standard import. Each one has its own format.
I guess so,
probably.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. And then in this case, like I've just been experimenting with each of those. So like I use deduce for one class and then I use MaxQDA for a different one. So I haven't really chosen one, but they're all pretty similar in terms of they're basically highlighting and coding and stuff like that.
Hi, thank you for this. My name is Jillian. I'm actually the product manager for EndNote. So you're talking about things that are very up my street. So you kind of mentioned it, but you know, in the interest of time, it went kind of quick. Could you go into more detail about the citation managers that you've used and exactly where they were you were struggling with them? So that's my first question. And the second question is more of an invitation if you would be interested in being part of our user testing group going forward for EndNote, because we would like to be able to make some of the annotation capabilities in EndNote more robust.
Okay, so the first question, what I found was that, for example, like with Zotero, I could put the documents in there, I could have the citation, and I could take notes, but it didn't seem to cut across all the articles like the tagging and Hypothesis does. So for example, if I like the idea of having the findings and recommendations and those types of things, I just didn't see an easy way to sort of tag all of these things across all the articles and then pull up, okay, let me see the recommendations across these five articles or whatever, and very easily, and also have those little quotes for each separate annotation. And it's possible, I mean, I didn't spend a lot of time on all that. Basically, I, you know, sort of started using them, and after, you know, a little bit, I'd be like, kind of moving on. It doesn't seem to be doing what I want it to do. But that was the primary thing, was just that ability to sort of tag things as you're reading with particular things that you'd be writing in your paper, and then very easily be able to pull up just those items one at a time as you're writing the paper, and then pull the ideas together and synthesize them. And as for the second one, time permitting, I'm always game for doing some end user trials and so on. Was there another question? No, okay.
Kind of a comment or a...
Could we use the mics, though, because there are people who don't hear well? And
yeah, so thank you very much. I found that talk very interesting. I kind of went through a similar journey. In my case, I used to be one of the main authors of the Mendeley desktop software. And now I work at Hypothesis on their software. And I think the thing that I missed most, or that was kind of wrong about the way, or not so, that severely constrained how useful the kind of annotation and note-taking tools in Mendeley were, is that it really wasn't of the web. For example, annotations in Mendeley don't have a URL. So that means you can't share them. There isn't like something you can plug into your browser or give to someone else. Any kind of tool that does anything with links, you can't kind of get a representation of that. There's no, like, all of the things that come for free when you design stuff in a sort of a webby way is missing. I think there's kind of specific affordances that you might see as an end user, but as someone who's like a little bit more technical or a little bit more adept with the tools like you are, that's definitely the thing I think is that is missing, I think, from some classical tools.
Thank you, and thank you all.